Coming up next on Good Looks, how to handle your barbering needs the right way. Good Looks, where we talk about the do's and don'ts of cosmetics. We'll get you to not only look good, but feel good too. I'm your host, Dee Gay.
And I'm Mike Zuba. We want to remind everyone at home that this is a call-in show. If you have any questions about today's topic, please give us a call at 1-800-901-9238. Today we're going to learn about barbering the traditional way. But before we get started, let's check in at a local barbershop. Today in the studio for a demonstration are barbers Johnny Sutliff and Raymond Struther. And with them are their models, Tyler Sullivan and Jamie Vega. All right, Johnny, let's go ahead and start with you. What are you going to be doing today?
Today on Tyler, we're going to do a low taper on the sides using a 2. Then we're going to do a lot of texture on the top, styling everything forward, and a little quiff on the front.
Very nice. Mm-hmm. All right, let's go ahead and get started. So, Mike, have you noticed barbering's one of the oldest professions?
Oh, Dee, I thought the oldest profession was something else. Oh, my.
Well, now, let's just say barbering's the oldest profession.
Okay.
But anyway, we've seen a resurgence of barbering coming back, so it's nice to see that. Barbershops popping up everywhere. So, Johnny, explain to us what you're going to be doing today.
All right, starting off, I'm going to use a 2 on my clippers here just to set my first guideline in. Just going up and flicking out. Coming around, we're going to even it up with his beard. I like to take my guideline just to the back. And then I'll switch sides, do the same on this side.
Johnny, do you always work from the front to the back? Is that where you pick up where you're going to
Yeah, I like to
guide.
Yeah, I like to start on the front on one side and then go towards the back, then jump to the other side and then connect it in the back.
How did you arrive at this haircut for this gentleman? Did he come in with a picture? What happened? How did
I've actually cut Tyler's hair a few times already. This is kind of a style that he's had for a good little while. Works good for him.
What styles are you seeing right now, Johnny, that are really popular with the men?
Right now, a lot of weight on the sides. Weight lines are kind of in right now.
Do you see a trend of it getting longer, men's hair getting a little longer, or what is actually happening out there?
I think fades are kind of, I mean, the fade is always going to be popular, but I think having a little bit more hair on the sides, more sheer cuts are becoming a lot more popular.
Yeah, explain to our viewers what a fade means.
Fade can be from skin up. You know, a lot of times it's a bald fade right down to the skin and then tapered up. Sometimes it's, you do like a shadow fade where it's like a one, so there's a little bit of hair left over.
So Johnny, is it fair to say it's just a taper? It's a real close taper?
Yeah, I'd say that.
All right, we have a phone call. Caller, go ahead with your question.
Hi, my name is Denise. I'm calling from Daytona, and I'd like to know, what is the best option to prevent razor bump?
The best option to prevent razor bump? Mike, you want to handle that?
Would be probably using a gel-type shaving cream or foam. And when you're actually doing it, don't cut against the grain of the hair. Shave with the grain of the hair. And you can also have that with bumps on their head. When somebody's shaving their head, you can also get that if that same thing occurs. You want to make sure you're using the right product, the gel, for actually, it helps the razor glide better on the skin.
All right, Johnny, how often would somebody with this hairstyle have to go into the barbershop to get their hair cut?
I'd say the longest you'd want to wait is 3 weeks, but I would say closer to 2 weeks, around that area. Because the shorter the hairstyle, the more often you want to get it cut if you want to keep that look.
And with this style that you're cutting this gentleman now, what's going to be his maintenance, his daily maintenance? Is it a wash and go? Is there a lot of product that he's going to have to use on it?
You could really do it anyway. Because of the amount of texture I'm going to be giving him, he could kind of just wake up, roll out of bed, and be totally fine. Throw a little water in it, maybe. Mm-hmm. Just kind of tussle it around. Or if you'd like to, he can, you know, slick it a little bit and kind of have a more refined look.
Because, you know, we're guys. Some of us really want to maintain and put a lot of product in our hair.
Absolutely.
And then other times we just want to wash and go. Get out as fast as we can.
I'm a product guy, as you can. This doesn't just roll out of the bed like this.
I was getting ready to ask you that, Johnny. What do you have on your hair?
Oh, boy. I've got a Ruzil matte pomade and a hairspray. Mm-hmm. Lots of blow drying.
And then you need product.
Yes, absolutely.
You need product.
Absolutely.
If you want to look your best, use product.
There's product, and the products we use are designed basically for men's hair, okay? Because it doesn't have as much shine, correct? And it's a more of a matte product.
Right.
Can men say, oh, I can use my girlfriend's gel, or I can use her spray, or?
Not usually. I mean, it depends on the style. If you have a lot of texture, a matte is usually better because matte is going to show off the texture better. The more shine, the more texture is hidden. Kind of the same with like paint.
When you do a style like this, do you teach your client like how to blow dry it? You said a lot of blow drying, like for a pompadour, do you teach them how to blow dry it?
Absolutely,
nice.
Yep.
That's a good point, Dee. That's nice because sometimes we think, oh, we leave that barber shop and we're ready to go, but we have to maintain it when we leave there. So we need some lessons, right? Mm-hmm. Guys, somebody needs to teach us how to take care of our hair and make it look as good as when we left your chair.
Absolutely.
And you want your client walking around looking as good as when they left because, you know, they're your best form of advertisement.
That's right. That head out there walking down the street. How many times does somebody stop you, Dee, and say, oh, great haircut, you know?
Right. I always tell them when they ask me who cut my hair, I always say Dee. I get more clients that way. So we noticed you wet the hair because you're getting ready to go in with some scissors on the top.
Yep. I wet everything on top And then I'm just kind of combing it into the place that it's going to sit once it's finished, just to kind of get an idea of where I need to cut.
So it's fair to say all men's haircuts don't have to be all clipper work, right?
That's correct. That's correct. I feel like there's a bit of more creativity in sheer work, kind of elegance, you know.
So you're like an artist, but the medium you're using is actually the hair, right?
Absolutely.
Instead of a canvas and paint.
Absolutely.
What is that technique you're doing right now, Johnny?
Right now I'm point cutting. This is going to give it a lot of added texture. It's not going to take out a whole lot of length, but it's going to take out some bulk.
And that gives him a lot of movement on the top.
Absolutely.
And mm-hmm. That separation that you're looking for when you apply that product.
Right.
That's why the product selection would be so important, right, Dee?
Yes.
Because that's how they're going to get that style that they want.
Yeah, if you really want to show off the texture, some sort of matte or low shine pomade would be a good idea.
So like we said before, the maintenance on this is about every 10 to 14 days back in the barbershop keep it looking fresh where you never really need a haircut, right?
Right, exactly. It's like it's just always that way.
Just for our viewers out there, if you're looking for a profession, barbering is where it's at because there's a 20% growth right now. We have barbershops calling us daily looking for barbers, so we never have a hard time placing barbers. So always a need for barbers. Barbershops are popping up in every plaza. So it's always good to know, never have to struggle to find a job if you're a barber.
And men's grooming's popular now.
Yes,
it's coming
is.
Back. And barbershops, as Dee, as you said, are mm-hmm. there's one almost on every corner. But there's enough of us guys out there to fill those chairs.
Yes, there is. Yeah, so a little bit about how to train to be a barber. So you go to school, 40 weeks. We always like to say in less than a year, you can become a barber. 40 weeks, 1,200 hours. And then once you take your state licensing exam, you can start working in a barbershop. It's actually that easy. You have to have some talent, but we've had people come in to the school, you know, that have been cutting hair their whole life and they just need that license. And then we had other people that it's just an interest and they start and they develop the skills and they become very successful.
And some people start out, right, Dee, with it's self-enrichment mm-hmm. and then all of a sudden they blossom and they end up going and working in a shop, in a barber shop. Mm-hmm. So everybody has different a way of looking at it when they join a program like this. Where else can you change your life in such a short time?
Exactly. And make the money that a barber makes. I mean, they really make good money, so.
How long should it take, Johnny, for a haircut? How long can somebody expect to stay in your chair?
I mean, right now, where I'm at, I'd say 30 minutes or so, about 2 an hour. Mm-hmm. I'd like to get that down to maybe 15 to 20 minutes, but it also depends on the cut.
Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah, the average barber can do 2 to 4 cuts an hour at $20 a haircut. You know, you do the math.
Mm-hmm.
And depending on how many hours a week you work, you can figure out about what you make. Johnny, I noticed that you're going in on the sides at an angle. What are you doing that for?
Right now I'm connecting the sides to the top. I've done everything up here already, and I've also already tapered up on the sides. So now if I go into these corners here and I grab this, you'll see that short here, short there, just nip off this little area right here, and now it's connected.
So it's like connect the dots, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much
there's a technique for
everything. Connect the dots. You start with the guide and end up to match everything up to it.
Yep.
That's actually coming together very nicely. It's looking good.
It's looking good, Johnny.
Good.
That's kind of how I found that I wanted to do it. I was just watching YouTube videos and the techniques just started clicking in my head and I was like, I want to give that a shot and I'm not looking back now.
Yeah, now will you need to do a little blow drying on that to finish it up or?
I don't think I'm going to blow dry on it. I think I'm going to give it a little bit of a wet look. I'm going to do a little bit of texturing. Just to kind of clean up some lines, soften a little bit of the lines right here. So I use my texturing shears just to kind of nip those lines there and make it flow better.
And I see you blended it into his beard, the upper part of his beard, where his actual sideburn is.
Mm-hmm.
How close can you take that area? Can you take that pretty close? That's really like detail, right, of the haircut?
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, at the end I'd go in with a detailer and just clean up all these lines right here and make it really crisp and down into the beard, just to give everything a really nice finished look.
Can that detailing be done with a straight razor?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You get an even crisper line with a straight razor.
All right, Johnny. Thank you for that. And
yeah, absolutely.
In a few minutes, we'll check back in with you and see the finished product.
Sounds good. Thank you.
All right. Oh, we have a phone call. Go ahead, caller, with your question.
Hey, this is Debbie from Port Orange. My question is, what is the toughest hairstyle that you've had to cut or that you've ever had to cut?
All right, we'll turn that over to our barbers. The caller wants to know, we'll start with you, Ray. What's the toughest haircut you've ever had to cut on a client?
I'm not going to say it's the toughest haircut. I think what we look at is people hair grow different. I think that's where it comes into the challenge that we face. For an example, I can have a client, his hair may have what we call a twirl in it, mm-hmm. and it may grow one way, say to go towards the right, then another portion of the hair maybe somewhat have a wave or curly pattern, and it may go a different direction. So when you find the hair itself has a different growth pattern, I think that's the challenge. Because uncommonly, you're going to cut the hair, basically, it's going to be like we commonly style now with the tapered, or you're going to have something that is a round shape, or maybe some graduated type shape in terms of cutting the hair. But I think the hair growth is where the challenge come in. So I've had clients where there's been challenge and I had to seek, say, the assistance of another professional to come in and to assist me with that. So I think that's the growth pattern is where
growth
the challenge.
Pattern and texture, I would assume, has a lot to do with the haircut and
yes.
the style, because, you know, how about head shape, bone structure?
Mm-hmm. That plays a role as well. Yes, sir.
All right, Ray, let's go ahead and get started with you and let you explain to us what you're going to be doing to your client today.
Yep, my client Jamie came in today for we're doing a tapered on him as well. Can you lean up, please? He came in, he had a picture, he showed me exactly what he's looking for from a previous haircut, which was very helpful to me. So what we're doing here, we'll start out with a number one guide on the clippers, and it's open. And I would be tapering him. Once I taper the side, I would bring it up to a point. Then very little will be done to the top, and we will also texturize the top, blending it in with the side, which that is a very popular cut for most men today. And we will also take and have his beard and the sideburns all flowing evenly into the haircut.
Ray, you mentioned that your client brought you a picture. Do you like it when your client brings you a picture? And
yes, when the client brings a picture, I look at it as effective communication, that where we are actually understanding each other. I understand what the client wants. He basically has demonstrated and explained to me by showing me that picture exactly what he's looking for in terms of the style and cut. Mm-hmm. So by doing that, again, like I say, I think that's one of the best ways of communicating the style and the cut that the client wants. So mm-hmm. I would recommend to anyone that desire a haircut, if you can take your barber a photo or a style in which you desire, it would definitely help communicate that with your barber.
Mm-hmm. How would you classify this haircut? Would you classify it as a traditional haircut or a more trendy haircut? How would you, like, if somebody was to come in, what would they ask for? If they see this at home and they wanted to go to the local shop, what could they ask for?
Well, I would say this haircut is, today is trending. Many of, you see the young people are wearing it. It's very acceptable, I think, in the business world, particularly men that are wearing beards nowadays. It's a very, very, it's trendy, but yet it's professional. It also has an old concept, I think,
Years ago, I think many of us got tapered, you know, high fade, and I think it's coming back.
Do you have like 10 days to the barbershop with your dad on Saturday, right? Is that what, what you're talking about, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. It was them days. And I'm kind of turning a little bit here with the chair to give you hopefully a clear view of what is taking place with the clippers as we cut here. And you can see I'm letting the clippers do the work. Once I get this line like I want it, I come back and I will work on the part a little below it, and then I will come back and blend the top portion in.
I love the styles today, the pompadours and everything. It reminds me of James Dean, and everything that comes around goes back around. So everything old is new again.
Now, come on, your mother and father must have told you about James Dean. You're not old enough for that, Dee.
I do like the looks, though, that guys are wearing right now.
This is perfect size.
Very trendy, very stylish.
Mm-hmm. I think it's giving you exactly what you want. Your hair laying down very nice. Yeah.
What about his neckline, Ray? Tell us about the different styles that men like their necklines.
I would say with the younger generation today, what I see, the younger generation do not want that solid block across the back. They want it tapered, they want it blend very nicely. And Jamie here has a very, I don't know if you can see or not, but he has a very beautiful natural growth. So I'm gonna work with that. And it tapes in very, very nice. He got a nice, I would say, grade of hair, and the thickness in his hair and all is very nice. Mm-hmm. And it's aligned for what I see as a very, very beautiful cut. But the neckline, I would work on it. We'd get it nice. Blend it in very well and taper it.
Ray, why don't you turn him around to the camera so we can see that neckline, so our viewers out there can see what the neckline actually looks like?
Yeah, he has a sorry about that. Yeah, he has a natural here. This is what I'm saying. But when I finish, I would taper it off here, but it really grows very nice coming up to the occipital bone here as high it grows. Very, very nice. So this is what I'm doing.
He also has a nice thickness to his hair, a lot of density, and looks very nice.
Yes.
Got a nice head of hair that would make a lot of men jealous.
Yes, it would. I'm looking, I'm thinking, wish I had more. So your maintenance with that, are you the type of guy that likes to maintain your hair once it's cut? Do you put a lot of product in it, or do you just wash and go?
Jamie and I had a conversation earlier during the consultation about the need for men to use some type of product in the hair and also with the beard. We talked about that based on the fact that he does have a beard and the importance of maintaining the hair with a nice product. Particularly when you're blow drying, it's important to make certain that something is in the, a product is in the hair that will allow the hair not to over dry, to help basically put the oil and the pH back into the hair itself, to use a type of product that would help. And it varies for different people as to what works for them and what's best for them. But I would say to you, if you're working with a professional barber should be able to give some advice. And particularly if you visit with him more than once, that particular barber should be able to make some recommendations for his clients, and particularly advise the client to use products from a beauty supply shop versus some of the basic retail stores.
So a barbershop should be able to supply, correct, whatever the client needs to actually style their hair or maintain it until their next trip to the barbershop? And I'm sure there's a lot of different lines out there.
I agree with you. Yes, sir, that's correct.
And we all have our little favorite product, right, Dee? We all have our favorite things that we use.
Yes. Some barbershops do not sell supplies, but the barber himself should be able to make that recommendation to the client as to what type of products and where to go for the products. The barber has to buy supplies for himself, and he should have a good contact that the client can use.
I notice now, Ray, you're going up into the higher up into the hair.
That is correct. I'm blending it now. I'm blending the top with the sides, and that's what I'm doing. I'm just taking my time and I'm gonna work it. I work it all the way around, and that's what I'm doing. Taking away that thick line. I don't want my client, don't want Jamie to walk out here with a thick line like his hair is in layers. In turn, okay. I want it to blend and blend nicely. I don't want obvious lines.
Ray. Thank you, Ray. That was very nice. And now let's go back to Johnny and see a little bit of the finished product that Johnny's done. You want to tell us a little bit, Johnny?
Sure, yeah. I just put a matte clay in here so we can see all the texture that's going on up here. Mm-hmm. Got all kinds of choppy texture in here and a nice even taper down to the neckline.
All right. Well, thank you, Johnny. That looks really good. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. If you were not able to get all your questions in, feel free to email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu or check us out anytime on our YouTube channel. Thank you again for joining us on Good Looks.